Welcome to the last topic of this fourth unit of wireless communication networks, unit 4, equalization and diversity. The last topic of this fourth unit is capacity of a cellular systems. Capacity of a cellular systems. How to calculate the capacity of a cellular system? That is, nothing but how many number of users and how to overcome the interference and number of channels. We discussed in this topic. Here first, before going to the capacity of cellular system, first we have to discuss about channel capacity. Here, what is the channel capacity? Here, the channel capacity is defined as the maximum number of channels or users that can be provided in a fixed frequency band. Nothing but, suppose they are given 800 megahertz to 850 megahertz frequency band they are given. That is 850 minus 800. That is the final we are getting 50 megahertz. Here in this 50 megahertz, how many number of users can occupy and how it can be utilized is called as a channel capacity. Here in this radio capacity. Here the radio capacity depends upon spectrum efficiency, nothing but how the users are utilized but given spectrum. In that spectrum, whether it is useful or not, whether it is occupied for the total time, or is there any wasted spectrum like this. It depends upon radio capacity. To determine this radio capacity, we are going for use two terms, that is carrier to interference ratio, C/B ratio. The second one is channel bandwidth. Channel bandwidth, that is two parameters to required to calculate radio capacity, that is carrier to interference ratio C/I and channel bandwidth PC. Here what is meant by interference? Here the interference is nothing but the base station receiver will come from the subscriber units in the surrounding cells. Nothing but it is called the reverse channel interference. Here, what is meant by reverse channel? From mobile station to base station. Is there interference occurs from between mobile station to base station transmission side? It is called the reverse channel interference. Suppose, is there interference occurs from a signal transmits from base station to mobile station? It is called the forward channel interference. Two interferences, forward and reverse. Forward nothing but base station to mobile station, reverse nothing but mobile station to base stations. Here we already discussed in the first unit co-channel cells. What are the co-channels? Two cells having same frequencies called the co-channel cells. The distance between that two co-channels are capital D. What is D? Frequency reuse distance. Frequency reuse distance. What is my capital R? Cell radius. Then co-channel interference reduction factor. Co-channel interference reduction factor R. Co-channel reuse ratio. Capital Q equal to D by R. Capital Q equal to D by R. That is, now based upon this Q equal to D by R, we have to calculate carrier to interference ratio. Here, see this figure. Here, the layout of this cellular layout is hexagonal shaped cells. Here, in this, we are fixed based upon the frequency reuse distance. The same set of frequency can be used for different locations. How to fixing of this? Frequency for different locations based upon the n equal to I square plus ij plus j square formula. Here now I am assuming that n equal to 4, that is the cluster size n equal to 4. See this one, the center cell B2. The center cell B2, from this B2 surroundings, number of B again in the first tier, 4 B2s are coming. Now, the signal transmitted from p2 to b2 center b2 likewise. That is, we are getting co-channel interference. That is, four co-channel base stations are with interfering with serving base station. Here we have to take two distances, d0 and dk. Here, what do you mean with d0? The distance from serving base station to user. Here, this is the user. This is a base station. The interference, the distance between these two here is d0. Dk, interference. So our distances dk from the user. There's an interference coming from co-channels. Co-channels. From this figure, C by I, which is equal to d0 power of minus n0 divided by summation k equal to capital M dk power of minus nk. Here, what is the m? Number of co-channels, where n0 is path loss exponent. What is mean by d0? Distance from desired base station to the mobile. Desired base station to the mobile. What is mean by dk? Distance from kth cell from the mobile. Distance of kth cell from the mobile. What is mean by nk? This is also from path loss exponents from kth infinite base station. Already we are calculated in the first unit how to calculate this C by ratio. Suppose now we had assumed that from the center cell to co-channels, we are assuming that equal distance capital D. Suppose the number of co-channels, now we are assuming that 6 co-channels, then C by I, which is equal to d0 power minus n divided by 6 times of d minus n. Right. Suppose we had assumed that the d0, which is equal to r, that is the frequency reuse distance, which is equal to radius of a cell, then we have to calculate carrier to interference ratio minimum. Then substitute in the above equation d0, which is equal to r. Then automatically we are getting 1/6 times of r by d power of minus n. It is greater than or equal to C by I. You know, Q equal to D by R. Substitute in this equation number 17. Then Q equal to 6 times of C by I minimum of power of 1 by N. This is a co-channel reuse factor. Now we have to calculate the data capacity. Now, till now we discussed about C by ratio calculation for the based upon this figure example. Now we are calculating the radio capacity of a cellular system, small m, which is equal to bt by bcn. What is m? Radio capacity metric. What is bt? The total allocating spectrum for the system. What is bc? Channel bandwidth. What is capital n? Number of cells in a frequency reuse pattern. You know that q, what is the relation between q equal to d by r? What is meant by d equal to root 3n into r? All we discussed in first unit, right? Then numerator demand R can be cancelled. Finally, Q equal to root 3N. Substitute based upon this, Q equal to root 3N. Substitute in the equation number 19. Then small m, radio capacity, which is equal to BT by BC into Q square by 3. You know Q value in the equation number 18. Then m equal to BT by BC multiplied with 6 by 3 power n by 2 C by I minimum of power of 2 by n. You know the path loss exponent. What is the fixed path loss exponent value? N equal to 4. Then substitute n equal to 4. Then m value, which is equal to bt by bc into root of 2 by 3 times of C by I minimum. This is about radio capacity in terms of radio channels per cell. Right, now we are calculating carrier to interference ratio for minimum. We have to check what is the exact voice quality, whether the voice quality is coming better or not. At that time, we are going for C by I of equalization. For better voice quality, we are going for C by I for equalization. Then what is the relation between scat interference ratio equalization, carrier to interference with minimum, and B, C. That is, the relation is C by I equalization, which is equal to C by I minimum multiplied with BC by BC, BC dash of whole square. What is meant of BC dash here? Channel bandwidth for different system. Here by this, like this, till now we discuss only for analog system. Now we are going for calculating the for digital cellular systems. That is the digital cellular system C by I, which is equal to EB RB by I, which is equal to EC RC by I. What do you mean by EB? What do you mean by RB? EB is nothing but energy per bit. RB nothing but channel bit rate. Similarly, we have to go for encoding. EC is nothing but the energy per code symbol. Energy per code symbol. RC nothing but rate of channel code. Then we have to calculate the ratio for C by I to C by I equalization. That is C by I divided by C by I equalization, which is equal to EC RC by I divided by EC dash RC dash by I, which is equal to BC dash by BC whole square. Suppose RC and BC are linear and interference level can be same. For two different digital systems, so now we are calculating then EC by EC dash, which is equal to BC dash by BC power of 3. Why? Because two different systems. We increase different systems. Right. Now, we have to compare the capacity for a radio system for FDMA technique, which is equal to BT by capital M root of 2 by 3 of C by I. This is about FDMA technique. And CDMA and TDMA, which is nothing but which are digital type of cellular systems, which improves the capacity 3 to 6 times based upon the analog systems. Why? Because which is having MAHO, that is mobile assigned handoffs is there, and better link performance is there, and which is utilized more spectrum, and which monitors the neighboring base stations, and which is used time slots. That's why the capacity can be improved by 3 to 6 times. And which is also used this adaptive channel allocations, right? Here, based upon this, now we are going for comparison of the air that is analog with digital type of cellular systems. You see this one, AMP is nothing, AMPS is nothing but analog type. GSM, USDC, and PDC is nothing but digital type. Here, for first, the parameter is bandwidth in terms of megahertz. The bandwidth available for AMP analog system is 25, for digital also 25 megahertz. Number of 5 channels for our analog system is 833, but we are going for digital is 1000 2500 3000. That is, whenever the number of 5 channels are increases, number of users entered into the network also increases. Next, frequency reuse in AMPS is 7 and GSM is 4 or 3, USDC is 7 or 4, PDC is 7 or 4. Next, number of channels for each base station is in AMPS 119, in GSM 252 or 333, in USDC is 357 or 625, in PDC is 429 or 750. Similarly for traffics, here the traffic can be calculated by intent of air lengths per square kilometer. For AMPS is 11.9, for GSM is 27.7 or 40, for USDC is 41 or 74.8, and PDC is 50 or 90.8. Similarly, for capacity gain, for AMPS 1, for GSM is 2.3 or 3.4, for USDC is 3.5 or 6.3, for PDC is 4.2 or 7.6. This is a comparison with analog with digital cellular system. Right. This is about the capacity of a cellular systems. Here we are calculating channel capacity and radio capacity based upon the C by I ratio. Based upon the C by I ratio. Do you have any query? Type your query in a chat box. Thank you. Thank you very much for attending this session.